What's up, guys? Apple released iOS 13.6 beta 2 to the developers, and the public beta will be getting it shortly as well. We are going to take a look at the changes, the bugs, the performance, and the battery life, as well as whether you should update or not. But before we continue, why did Apple make this iOS 13.6? So if you remember, beta 1 was iOS 13.5.5. So we had the same thing that happened with iOS 13.4.5, where after two betas, it went to 13.5. So let's just see why iOS 13.5.5 went to 13.6. And the main reason for this, for the change in the number, is because of the new health features that we're going to get into shortly. So starting off with the update size, it came in about 340 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Of course, this will vary depending on your device and from which software version you are coming from, but it should be between 300 and 400 on most of your devices. Now, if we head over into settings and general and the about section, we can see that we're running 17G5045C. And the C at the end means we will have definitely at least one more beta or more if it's released to the public. Now, if we head a little lower, we can see that the modem firmware remains at 1.06.00, which didn't change for the past, many betas. So if you had any connectivity issues, then you will probably not have them fixed in any of these betas. Now, let's take a look at all the changes. So if you remember from my iOS 13.5.5 beta 1 video, there were no visible changes. There was really nothing. It was mostly in the code itself. But in 13.6, there are a few changes. So the first one being in the health app. So if we head over into the health app, okay, and we go here, we can see that under this section, we didn't have this category, which is symptoms. Now we have a category symptoms. When you click on it, you have all these kind of symptoms that you might be having, and then each of them gives you an explanation, as well as, for example, for chills, you can have for the day, the week, the month, the year, whether they're severe, moderate, mild, present, or not present. So if you have these symptoms, you can put them in, and then maybe your doctor can have a more clear idea of your symptoms and how they are developing. So the other change is under settings and then software update, where you will have, where you can customize automatic updates. So we have another toggle which allows you to choose if you want to download or install, or one or the other. So if you just want to install or download, you can do either or, whichever you like doing. And the third change is with COVID-19 contact tracing, which can be found under privacy, health, and it's up here, COVID-19 exposure logging. So this feature was not available in all regions or all states in the United States. Now you actually have it available in many, many more regions. So for example, here in Hong Kong, it was not available over the past few betas, but now it is actually here. Of course, we don't have an app yet, but when the app will be coming, then you will be actually having it here, and this will be working. So otherwise, there is nothing more that I found right now, but after using it more, I will definitely update you. So what about the bugs? Well, in this beta or the previous beta, as a matter of fact, I didn't have any bugs. So in mail, people said in 13.5.5 that the mail app got some fixes, but since I didn't have any of those bugs in mail besides a few which were effectively fixed, I cannot say if all of them have been fixed. But regarding lag or stutter or the animations or anything, everything seems to be smooth. Now, regarding performance, performance is really good as well, and it seems to be identical to what was in the previous betas and all the other versions before. Of course, in Geekbench, we have a little bit of a decrease in the scores, but nothing that will actually affect your daily usage or whatever you're doing on your phone. Now, regarding battery life, so if you head over there, battery life has been really good for me throughout the past few betas. Definitely, then it depends on how much you are on your phone, but for me that's not a lot, so the battery life is really good. Of course, that will also depend on your battery health, so your maximum capacity, as well as what you do on your phone, whether it's hardware intensive or not. So now, should you update? Yes, if you are on the betas, whether it be the public beta or the developer beta, go ahead and update. You'll definitely have the two new features, some security improvements and other stability improvements across the board, but there shouldn't be any big problems, especially this far down in iOS 13. Well, this is it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, then please do leave a like, subscribe, and hit the bell to stay notified when I release my next video. If you missed my previous video, then please click the card shown up there. Okay, take care, and I'll see you in my next video.